正好是八点钟 ，OK， it's job eight. To start, please let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Martin Wan, the moderator of today's conference opening ceremony. I am the vice president and the secretary general of the Alliance of Acupuncture and Chinese Medicine of Canada. The secretary general and a member of organizing committee of the first international academic conference of acupuncture and traditional Chinese medicine of Canada. Currently, I'm a research scientist focusing on nutraceutical research and also an adjunct teaching faculty at Central College in BC, Canada. 首先让我介绍一下我自己，我是王天山博士，我是今天大会开幕式的主持人，我是加拿大中医针灸联盟副主席和秘书长，第一届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会的秘书长和组委会成员。目前我既是一位天然健康产品开发的专职研究人员，同时也是加拿大 BC 省中央学院的兼职教师。Ladies and gentlemen, dear distinguished speakers, fellow TCM and integrative medicine professionals, teachers and students from all around the world, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. 女士们、先生们、尊敬的演讲嘉宾、全球参会的中医药和整合医学同道师生们，早上好，中午好，晚上好。At this special moment, it is my pleasure to meet with all of the guests and professional peers in the first international academic conference of acupuncture and traditional Chinese medicine of Canada being held virtually in Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada. 在这个特殊的时刻，我非常荣幸的与各位嘉宾和参会专业同行相聚云端，第一届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会网络会议。According to the conference program, please let me first introduce co-president, organizing committee, Dr. Guo Jianhuang, president of the Alliance of Acupuncture and Chinese Medicine of Canada, AACMC, to deliver a welcome address.根据大会议程，首先允许我有请本次大会共同主席、加拿大中医针灸联盟主席黄国健博士致辞。有请黄博士。
谢谢王天山博士的介绍。尊敬的参加本次大会的全球所有中医针灸气功专家。加拿大针灸中医学院的 全体师生，加拿大中医针灸联盟的常委委员、志愿者们、赞助商家及所有参会人员，大家好。今天是我们加拿大中医针灸人的大喜的日子，是我们加拿大中医针灸联盟成立以来首次与加拿大针灸中医学院联合举办的第一次国际学术大会。这次大会有来自16个国家和地区的近50名世界级的中医针灸专家相聚一堂，有近200名中医针灸同仁及学生参加本次大会。在全球新冠疫情肆虐黑暗时刻举办的网络大会，目的是希望通过搭建这样的一个平台，为大家相互交流利用中医中药、针灸气功等防止各种痛症、精神神经及心理疾病，提高人民的生活品质，做出我们应有的贡献，向参加筹备本届大会的所有人员表示衷心的感谢，祝愿本届大会能够取得圆满成功。Dear distinguished experts, teachers and students of Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine, CCATCM. committee members of the Alliance of Acupuncture and Chinese Medicine of Canada, AACMC, volunteers, business sponsors, and all attendees. Hello, everyone. Today is a happy day for our Canadian TCM and acupuncture service. We mark the first international academic conference jointly organized by the CCATCM since the establishment of AACMC. At this conference, nearly 50 world-class TCM and acupuncture experts from 16 countries and regions are gathered, along with nearly 200 traditional Chinese medicine and acupuncture attendees who will together participate in this conference. The purpose of this online conference held in this dark and uncertain times of global COVID-19 pandemic is to build a platform to communicate with each other and to use Chinese medicine, acupuncture, moxibustion, and qigong to prevent and treat various kinds of physical, mental, and neuropsychological diseases in order to improve people's quality of life. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to all those who participated in the preparing of this conference and wish all conference participants success over the coming 2 days. Thanks very much.
Thanks to Dr. Huang. 谢谢黄博士。Now, please let me introduce co-president, organizing committee, Dr. Diana Lee, president of the Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine, CCATCM, to deliver a speech. 下面有请本次大会共同主席、加拿大针灸中医学院院长李彤博士致辞。有请李彤博士。
Dear colleagues, students, friends, it is a great honor to Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine to co-host this special International Acupuncture and TCM Conference on Mental Health and Pain Management. On behalf of the Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine, I would like to extend my warmest welcome to everyone attending this conference. I would like to thank the volunteers who have made this event possible. Over the past 30 years, I have personally witnessed the development of acupuncture and the TCM in Canada. 30 years ago, there was no acupuncture clinic in Atlantic Canada. Today, there are hundreds. Special thanks to the CCATCM instructors who have shared their passion and the knowledge to train next generation acupuncture practitioners. The Canadian College of Acupuncture and the Traditional Chinese Medicine is located at Halifax, Nova Scotia. College facing beautiful Atlantic Ocean, have a great healing energy. CCATCM is the only private career college approved by the government in Atlantic Canada. Our students come from across Canada with a different age and background, but they all have one thing in common, their passion to heal. TCM practitioners play a vital role in health care of their community. It is very important to co-host such acupuncture and TCM conference on mental health in Canada today. We hope through this conference, the practitioner will better understanding on this topic. As a result, they will be benefit for even more people and improve well-being of our community. All my best wish to everyone and hope you enjoy this conference. Thank you very much. 同仁们、专家们，早上好。加拿大针灸学院很荣幸能够一起主办这次心理健康与痛症的国际学术大会。我谨代表加拿大针灸中医学院全体师生对出席大会的全体成员表达最热情的欢迎。我坚信每一位出席的人员必能从著名专家的讲演中受益。 合办这样的大会有其深远的意义。在过去30年里，我本人亲自见证了针灸与中医在加拿大的发展。30年前，在加拿大的东部四省没有专业的针灸诊所。经过加拿大针灸中医学院老师们的多年付出和努力，如今已有几百家专业针灸诊所服务我们的社区。 加拿大针灸中医学院处于美丽的海滨城市Halifax， 是东部四省中唯一获得政府批准的针灸中医学院。学生来自加拿大各省，有不同的年龄和背景，但是有一点共同，就是对中医和针灸充满强烈的兴趣和热爱。毕业成为合格的治疗针灸师后，在当地医疗系统和社区中起到了 重要的作用和影响力。在现在这个疫情期间，心理健康是一个大家都关注的问题。举行这样的大会非常重要。我们期望通过这样的国际针灸中医学术大会，医生们对此课题有更好的理解，结果能够造福更多的人群和改善我们社区的健康状况。祝各位万事如意，在大会有一个好的时光。谢谢大家。
Thanks to Dr. Lee and Xie Xie Li Tongbo Shi. The organization committee has received congratulatory letters from the Prime Minister and members of Parliament of Canada, as well as from the World Federation of Acupuncture Moxibustion Societies, the World Traditional Medicine Forum, the TCM American Alumni Association, and other professional societies. 本次大会收到加拿大总理和国会议员，以及世界针灸联合会、世界传统医学论坛、美国中医校友联合会和其他专业协会的贺信。I would like to ask Ms. Nina and Nina Chen to read a congratulatory letter from the Right Honorable Justin Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada. 下面有请 Nina Chen 宣读加拿大总理贺信，有请。
I am honored to present to you today a congratulatory letter on behalf of the Prime Minister of Canada. Dear friends, I am pleased to extend my warmest greetings to everyone attending the first international academic conference of acupuncture and traditional Chinese medicine, hosted by the Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine and the Alliance of Acupuncture and Chinese Medicine of Canada. This event provides researchers and practitioners in the field of traditional Chinese medicine and acupuncture a forum in which to share their knowledge and best practices. I am certain that everyone in attendance will benefit from the opportunity to learn from and network with their peers. It continues to be a challenging time for hosting and planning events. That is why I would like to thank the organizers for making this inaugural conference virtual so that it could take place. You can take pride in your commitment to education and professional development. Please accept my best wishes for a productive and rewarding conference. Yours sincerely, the Right Honorable Justin Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada.
Thank you, Anina. I would also like to ask Dr. Liu, Professor of TCM Acupuncture, Georgian College of the Applied Arts and Technology, Canada. 下面有请加拿大乔治亚文理学院中医针灸学教授刘东博士宣读总理的中文翻译贺信。好，谢谢主持人天山博士。下面请允许我宣读加拿大总理
Justin Trudeau 对本次大会的贺信。 我很高兴向参加由加拿大中医针灸学院和加拿大中医针灸联盟联合举办的首届加拿大中医针灸学术大会的所有专家们致以诚挚的问候。本次大会为中医针灸领域的研究人员和从业人员提供了一个论坛，以分享他们的专业知识和丰富的临床经验。我相信 参加会议的每个人能够与同行交流学习，并从这次大会中受益。 在目前仍然是充满困难和挑战的环境时刻，我要特别感谢大会组委会、筹备委员会举办这次网络视频学术大会，为各位专家学者在中医教育和学术发展方面的坚持和努力感到自豪。请接受我良好的祝愿，希望这次大会富有成效，圆满成功。此致敬礼，加拿大总理 Justin Trudeau， 2021年2月28日。
Thanks to Professor Liu. 谢谢刘东教授。Again, please welcome Professor Dr. David Liu to cast a video greeting from Professor Dr. Baoyan Liu, President of the World Federation of Acupuncture Moist Production Societies. 下面我们再有请刘东教授播放世界针灸联合会主席刘宝炎教授贺平视频贺信。落下
东京的大会主席，
有声音吗？
东京的各位女士们、先生们、针灸界的同仁们，大家新年好！喜闻加拿大第一届国际中医针灸学术大会召开，首先请允许我代表世界针灸学会联合会为大会的召开表示热烈的祝贺。针灸在中国已经有2000多年的历史，目前已经走向了世界，在183个国家都有着针灸的传播和应用。那么针灸不光能够治疗疾病，而且可以养生保健，延年益寿。在新冠肺炎的抗击之中，那么针灸也发挥了非常重要的作用。那么它在缓解呼吸障碍啊，舒缓患者心情，减轻症状方面发挥了非常重要的作用，不光对轻症的病人啊有作用，而且对重症的病人啊也发挥了非常好的这样的一些治疗的效果。那么本次加拿大这个学术交流会啊，以这个心理的针灸治疗心理疾病这方面啊，作为一个非常重要的和痛症啊，作为一个重要的选题，一个主题啊，我觉得非常重要。那么针灸，它通过人体的穴位，通过经络，通过神经系统，通过人体的各种调节的这种机制，啊，和人体自身的自稳态的系统，发挥着重要的作用。所以它没有副作用，对人的这种心理的调节啊，往往会起到非常重要的啊这样一种作用，所以也被广泛的应用在这个抑郁症、抑郁状态以及产后抑郁、痴呆等许多精神疾病的当中。所以我想大家通过这样一个交流，将会大大的促进针灸在心理调节、在痛症治疗方面啊作用的发挥。那么牛年我想精疲奋进，肯定会一扫这个疫情啊对社会的影响。让我们也共同来努力，让针灸在人类健康的当中啊发挥更大的作用，让针灸在人类健康卫生这个共同体的建设当中啊发挥更大的作用。预祝大会 圆满成功，也给大家拜年了，谢谢大家。
Thanks to Dr. Liu from China, give us a greeting. 谢谢刘宝云教授的祝贺。We are very grateful for the support of other professional societies. Next, please join me to welcome Professor Guo Chunbiao, Secretary General of the World Traditional Chinese Medicine Forum, to deliver speech. 本次大会非常感谢兄弟学会的大力支持。首先欢迎世界传统医学论坛秘书长郭群标教授致辞。
尊敬的大会组委会成员、各位嘉宾、各位专家、女士们、先生们，大家早上好。 Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. 一年之计在于春，春天是播种的季节，春天是放飞希望的季节，也是世界中医人奋发努力的季节。从天涯海角，从世界各地，我们共去美丽的国度加拿大，共同出席见证第一届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会盛大召开。名家荟萃，盛世如约，在新春之际召开的首届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会，必将鼓舞着全球中医界同仁以身载道，以术济世，奋发图强，精勤不倦，为中医学术和中医文化做出我们的努力和贡献。我谨代表世界传统医药论坛董志林主席和全体中医同仁们，向第一届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会的隆重召开表达热烈的祝贺和诚挚的祝福。 Traditional Chinese medicine is a medical discipline with complete theoretical system and definite clinical therapeutical effect. It is a miracle in medicine. It has made great contributions to the flourishing of Chinese nationalities over thousands of years.It is undertaking the task of the civil healthcare and the medical service together with modern medicine with irreplaceable position. TCM has been spread to the whole world in the long process of history and has actively boosted the progress of human civilization. Let's make joint efforts to stride forwardMaking greater contributions to human health and the international development of TCM. 这届盛会必将带给全球中医界丰硕的果实。庆祝首届加拿大中医针灸国际学术大会圆满成功。The World Traditional Medicine Forum greets old guests and doctors present. Wish.The Congress with the greatest success. Thanks for all of you. Best regards. Thank you.
Thanks to Dr. Guo. 谢谢郭博士。Now, let's warmly welcome Dr. 海和田, President of the TCM American Alumni Association, to deliver a speech.现在让我们热烈欢迎美国中医校友会校友联合会主席田海和博士致辞。
Thank you, dear friends and guests. Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Tian. I'm come from Florida, America. First of all, let's congratulate this wonderful conference, the first international academic conference on acupuncture and Chinese medicine of Canada.To be very successful. It's very honored to invite to present in this conference along with many other famous experts. This conference is very important during this time and also get attention from the higher leaders, the Canadian premier, and even give us congratulation letters. It's a wonderful honor. I'm so happy and to go along with other experts together to present our clinical experience. Hope everybody can get some benefit, apply to your patients, and to benefit more patients, get everybody health. I also represent American TCM Association and also TCM American Alumni Association, and hope our organization and Canadian Alliance for Acupuncture and Chinese Medicine to more communication and working together to promote the human health and internationally. My best wish to this conference, very successful. 各位领导、嘉宾、朋友们，大家好，我是田海河，在美国佛罗里达州恭祝首届国际针灸中医学术大会的胜利召开。我代表全美中药学会和美国中医校友联合会在这里恭祝大家这个新春快乐，因为现在也是新年。加拿大和美国是近邻，我们有很多相通和共同之处，文化背景、病人的这个疾病谱都是很相似。希望我们两个学会和有这个加拿大中医学院，还有我们呢加强合作，进行广泛的学术交流，共同提升我们国际上美国和加拿大以及世界各地的中医人的学术水平，使我们的病人得到受益。非常荣幸这次呢和众多的专家一起能够参与这次大会，受邀参与这次大会，分享我们的临床经验，互相学习，共同提高，提升我们的诊疗技术，再一次恭祝，首届这个国际中医针灸加拿大学术大会顺利成功。好，谢谢大家。
Thanks to Dr. Tian. 谢谢田博士。Lastly, we would like to introduce the organizer of this conference.Dr. Frank Ning Chen, Chairman of the Canadian College of Acupuncture and Traditional Chinese Medicine, CCATCM, to give an address. 最后，我们有请本次大会的主办单位加拿大针灸中医学院董事长陈时成博士致辞，有请。
Thank you very much, Dr. Wang. Dear ladies, gentlemen, and my fellow medical experts, it is my great pleasure to extend my warm greetings and best wishes to everyone participating in this international conference from Halifax, capital city of Nova Scotia, Canada. I would like to give my special thanks to all our medical experts for contributing your time, knowledge, and experience at this conference.I also want to give thanks to the Right Honorable Justin Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada, sending a congratulation letter to this conference. I extend my gratitude to Chairman Liu for virtually presenting his speech, and Secretary General Guo and Chairman Tiang for presenting an opening speech at this conference. COVID-19.Is still very severe at this present time, so it is very meaningful to be able to host this international conference on the topic of mental health and pain management. The data shows over 6 million people in USA and over 2 million people in Canada are still suffering from mental health. The pandemic perhaps doubled the number of patients.This is an excellent opportunity for the medical community to exchange knowledge and experience on this topic. Chinese medicine dates back over 4,000 years. It contains the philosophy and the wisdom of Chinese people from a long history. Chinese medicine holds the belief that the nature and the human are one, applying the concept of holism.It's focused on the preventive treatment of disease. It also states a clear and sound mind can help prevent disease. There is a very close relationship between the physical body and the emotions. In today's society, mental health, and emotional problem are major triggers of disease. Chinese medicine has shown great result in treating mental problem since the ancient time. Now, more and more people are experiencing the perfect combination between Chinese medicine and Western medicine across the whole world. They appreciate the excellent result from Chinese medicine. Chinese medicine is a precious gift from China to the whole world. In our lives, especially during this difficult time, we need faith, hope, and love. The greatest of this is love. I want to deeply give thanks to all the medical experts who contribute their love and passion at this conference. I also want to give special thanks to all the volunteers who have shown the hard work and the love in preparation for this conference. Without your support, all of this would not have been happening. Thank you again. I wish everyone happiness and success. Thank you very much. 女士们、先生们、专家同仁们，从加拿大新斯科舍省省会 Halifax 向你们致以最亲切的问候和送去最美好的祝愿。感谢专家们抽出宝贵的时间来分享知识和经验。感谢加拿大总理 Justin Trudeau 给大会发来祝贺信。感谢世界经典主席刘宝阳教授的视频主持。感谢国秘书长和田主席的讲话。在目前疫情依然严重的情况下，我们召开这样的一次国际性的会议，在心理健康和痛症方面相互交流，有其重要的意义。以前的资料显示，美国有600多万心理健康问题的患者，加拿大也有超过200多万。疫情期间，这样的数据只会成倍的增长。我们医学界对此题目在知识与经验上的交流与讨论，正是恰当的时候。中医有4000多年的历史，其中包含着中国人的一些哲学思想与智慧，特别是天人合一的整体观。中医历来重视治未病，精诚内守，病安从来。中医强调心理与身体的综合治疗，由精神和情志因素引起的身心疾病是当地社会的多发病。自古以来，中医在治疗心理疾病方面都有很好的疗效。现在，全世界的人们正从中医与西医的精准结合治疗中长期受益，体验到中医的博大精深。中医是中国送给世界的一份最好的礼物。在这个特别困难的时候，我们的生活更需要信心、希望和大爱，其中最伟大的就是爱。我再次深深地感谢各位专家在这次会议中所付出的爱心和热情。我还要特别感谢许许多多为大会的筹备付出时间与辛勤劳动的医务工作人员。如果没有你们的支持，我们不可能召开这样的一次国际会议。再次的感谢你们，祝各位幸福成功。 Thank you， 谢谢大家。
Thanks to Dr. Chen， 谢谢陈博士。On behalf of the organizing committee, I would like to take this opportunity to express my sincere appreciation to all of you. We are looking forward to the upcoming guest speakers, keynotes, and plenary sessions presentations. Your thoughts would let our members and participants to gain knowledge from your expertise and experience. 借此机会，我谨代表大会组委会向各位嘉宾表示衷心的感谢，期待各位嘉宾的专题演讲，使我们的会员和参会者从你的专业特长和经验中 获取知识。Now let's move on to the keynote presentation program. 大会专家演讲正式开始，开幕式 is called， 开幕式结束了，谢谢大家的参与。